So here I have a directory on my local machine, which contains a couple of files, and I want to put one of them into HDFS. All of the commands which interact with the Hadoop file system start with HadoopFS. So first of all, let's see what we have in HDFS to start with. I do that by saying HadoopFS minus ls. That gives me a listing of what's in my home directory on the Hadoop cluster. Because I'm logged into the local machine as a user called training, my home directory in HDFS is /user/training, and as you can see, there's nothing there. So now let's upload our purchases.txt file. We do that with HadoopFS minus put purchases.txt. HadoopFS minus put takes a local file and places it into HDFS. Since I'm not specifying a destination file name, it'll be uploaded with the same file name. So it takes a few seconds to upload, and now I can do another HadoopFS minus ls, and we can see that that file is now in HDFS. I can take a look at the last few lines of the file by saying HadoopFS minus tail, and then the file name, and that just displays the last few lines on the screen for me. There's also a HadoopFS minus cat, which will display the entire contents of the file, and we'll use that later. There are plenty of other HadoopFS commands, and as you'll probably have started to realize, they closely mirror standard Unix file system commands. So if I want to rename the file, for example, I can say HadoopFS minus mv, which moves purchases.txt, in this case to newname.txt. If I want to delete a file, HadoopFS minus rm will remove that file for me. So let's get rid of newname.txt from HDFS. I create a directory in HDFS by saying HadoopFS minus makedir and then the directory name. And now let's upload purchases.txt and place it in the myInput directory so that it's ready for processing by HDFS. Once I've done that, HadoopFS minus ls myInput will show me the contents of that directory, and just as I expected, there's the file.